and wonders in this place. Miracle signs and wonders in this place. Lord, we thank you for miracle signs and wonders in this place. Somebody out there, you may have given up, but I come to encourage you. Loves you no matter what you've been through,
no matter what you've been through,
and no matter what you're going through right now. Yes, you believe. Oh, miracle signs and wonders in this place.
Miracle signs and wonders in this place.
Miracle signs and wonders in this place.
Hey, so we come tonight, amen. Come to minister to Lisa. Amen. Let's thank God, amen. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Amen. Indeed, she told us to lay your hands on me, Jesus.
Yes.
I said, I don't mind.
No.
Do you mind the Lord laying his hands on me?
Yes.
Amen. I need the Lord to lay his hands on me every day.
Yes.
Every minute, every second. Amen. Every millisecond. Amen.
Yes,
I need the Lord to lay his hands on me.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. I thank God for his hands always being up on me. Amen. Do you thank God for his hands being up on me?
Yes.
Amen. You have amazing in his hands. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. You may have your seats at this time. Amen. I do honor the Lord. Amen. On tonight, who is the head of my life. Amen. Amen. We thank God for being saved on tonight, sanctified. Amen. Holy Ghost, filled, fire, baptized. Amen. And delivered in Jesus' name. Amen. I thank God. Amen. How many of you have that same testimony on tonight? And we're striving to get there. Amen. Amen. We thank and praise God. Amen. On tonight, amen. Amen. We do bring you greetings all the way from Heavenly Grace Gospel Word Network. We thank God for our pastor and our apostle, Little James Pearson Jr. on tonight. Amen. We thank God for those that graces the house on tonight. Come on, clap your hands and encourage yourself on tonight. It's all right to encourage yourself on tonight. Amen. We thank God for every listener here out there tonight that's tuned in by the way of our live stream on tonight. Amen. A live network on tonight. Amen. We thank God for you, amen, being a part, amen, amen, of the family. Amen. Amen. Just because, amen, you don't belong here as an official member, we still, amen, consider you as family on tonight.
Amen.
And we thank God for your continued support. Amen. And we just, amen, just ask you, amen, continue, amen. Amen. To tune in, amen, to hear the word of God. Amen. Amen. And it's all right, amen, if you want to share any of our, amen, of services, amen, to be a blessing to somebody. Yes, it's okay to share, amen. Amen. Because I've learned, amen, it's best to share the gospel and not the gossip. Amen.
Amen.
We have a lot of people sharing the gossip, but how many is sharing the gospel?
Amen.
Amen. We thank God, amen, for the gospel of Jesus Christ on tonight. Amen. Tonight we're going to talk about one word, and that word is free. Everybody say free.
Free.
Everybody say free.
Free.
Amen. Everybody say free again.
Free.
We talking about the word free on tonight. Amen. Amen. And this is our Bible study on tonight. Amen. After we go through our Bible study, we do have, amen, discussion. Amen. Close discussion. Amen. Anybody want to ask questions? Amen. Amen. Want to share? Amen. Amen. That's the opportunity. Amen. Because we, amen, we have Bible study to live, learn, and to grow. Amen.
Amen.
So we're going to talk about that word freedom tonight. Amen. Amen. When you think about the word free, amen, you think about, amen, coming away from something. Amen. Amen. First, I'm just going to start and give you a definition what the word free is on tonight, because it may be somebody that just may not know what the word free means on tonight. Amen. Amen. But free means not under the control or in the power of another, able to act or be done as one wishes. Amen. But tonight we're going to talk about the word free. And in talking about the word free, of course, we can't leave Jesus out. I don't want to leave Jesus out. Amen. Amen. Because when I look back over my life, he is the one that set me free one day. Who did he set me free? He set me free from the enemy. Amen. He set me free, amen, from what? My sins, amen. And I'm glad about that on tonight, amen. I'm glad, amen, that I allowed him to set me free. Amen. Back in those days, amen, with some of us, amen, and most of us, we weren't even born, amen. Amen. But a lot of people, they was enslaved, amen. We know a lot of our ancestors, they was in slavery, amen. Amen. They was bound for in chains, amen. They was under, amen, another man's control, another man's authority, amen. They couldn't go to sleep when they wanted to go to sleep. Amen. They couldn't wake up when they wanted to wake up. They couldn't eat when they wanted to eat. Amen. Amen. They couldn't go, amen. They couldn't do as they desire, amen. Because some of them, amen, they was bound by, amen, their slave masters. Amen. They was bound, amen. Amen. In chains, amen. Amen. But I thank God for Jesus Christ on tonight. If it had not been for Jesus Christ, amen, who was on our side, amen, tell me, where do we be on today? Amen. Amen. Well, that was a natural man way of being, amen, enslaved. But one day, amen, thank God for Jesus Christ, because he still had a part of it, amen. Amen. I thank God for Jesus Christ. One day, amen, we didn't have to experience that, amen. We didn't have to experience, amen, someone, amen, being our what? Our slave master. Natural man being what? Our slave master. Amen. We didn't have to experience, amen, somebody telling us to get up. Amen. Somebody telling us the time to go to sleep. Somebody telling us when it's time to eat or not to eat. And we was up under there. But we didn't have to go through that. We didn't have to experience that. But our ancestors, they did.
Amen.
But even in that, we thank God for the freedom that we have. Amen. A lot of people say America, amen, is the place where there is freedom.
Uh-huh.
But how many of you know in Jesus Christ is the best freedom in the world? Amen.
Amen.
Amen. When you think about the word freedom, I want you to consider it's not under the control and in the power of another, but able to act or be done as one wishes. Get your Bibles. Let's turn to 2 Corinthians on tonight. You know, we'll do a couple of verses on tonight so we can get a better understanding,
amen,
of what freedom truly means, amen. Because somewhere down the road, somewhere down the line, even when people have given their lives to the Lord, amen, they misunderstood what the word free means,
amen.
And tonight, amen, we're gonna go through what freedom means, amen. Amen. 2 Corinthians 3 and 17. The 17th verse, and now the Lord is that Spirit. And where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is what? Liberty. Liberty is another, amen, amen, word for freedom, amen. Amen. And on Sunday, amen, Apostle, he talked about, amen, the Spirit of God, amen. Amen. And he was talking about the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters, amen. And everything that God made, well, it was good, amen. Amen. And when we look at this scripture on tonight, so now the Lord is that Spirit. And by the Spirit of the Lord, there is liberty. But we all, with open face, behold it, as in a glass, the glory of the Lord, are changed into the same image from glory to glory, even by the Spirit of the Lord. So it was letting us know, even by the same Spirit of the Lord, amen, we're able to be changed into that same thing, that same image. Amen. He let us know tonight we can be set free on tonight if you're not free on tonight.
Amen.
Amen. Let's turn to St. John on tonight. St. John chapter 8 on tonight. Verse 36. Let me go ahead and pick up at verse 31. St. John 8:31. If you have it, say amen.
Amen.
Then said Jesus to those Jews which believed on him, if ye continue in my word, then are ye my disciples indeed. And ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall what? Make you free. They answered him that we be Abraham's seed and were never in bondage to any man. How sayest thou ye shall be made free? Jesus answered them and said, verily, verily, I say unto you, whosoever committed sin is what? The servant of sin. And the Son abided not in the house forever, but the Son abided ever. If the Son therefore shall make you free, ye shall what? Be free indeed.
Amen.
I know that ye are Abraham's seed, but ye seek to kill me, because my word hath no place in you. I speak that which I have seen with my Father, and ye do that which ye have seen with your Father. So tonight I want to, amen, go into that, because a lot of people, when they come on the Lord's side and they get saved, amen, and yes, amen, you put out that old man, amen, and you take on the new life in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
The word of God there told us that ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free.
Amen.
And it went on down and said, amen, that, amen, Jesus answered them and said, verily, verily, I say unto you, whosoever committed sin is the servant of sin. Amen. And let us know all the way down that the Son abided not, and the Son abided not in the house forever, but the Son abided forever. So if the Son therefore shall make you free, you shall be free indeed. So what I'm saying on tonight, amen, a lot of people, amen, they come on the Lord's side, amen. And they begin to talk, they begin to talk, and they begin to say, I'm free to do whatever I want to do. And when they say, I'm free to do whatever I want to do, let me tell you, people of God, you're messing up right there. Because when you come on the Lord's side, God's supposed to be your head. God, you don't allow God to lead and guide you into everything. Amen. Not just some things, but into everything. You're supposed to allow God to lead you. So when you come on the Lord's side of you, amen, you get in God and you say, I'm free to do whatever I want to do. Watch it now. Because see, you, when you make that conversation, you have to be, amen, so very careful with the words that you speak out your mouth. Because when you speak those words out your mouth, you say, I'm free to do whatever I want to do. Amen. That calls you to speak some things over your life that you will be doing that you think is God and it's not God.
Amen.
So true freedom is freedom in Christ Jesus. You said, well, how can I be free and God still got to lead and guide me? Amen. Without God, you will not even be breathing. Without God, amen, you wouldn't, amen, even have, amen, eyes to see on tonight for those of us that are blessed with eyes. Without God, you wouldn't have anything in this world. So be careful how you say, I do whatever I want to do. Because when you say, God is the head of my life. See, you contradicting yourself when you say, God is the head of my life. Then you turn around and say, I do whatever I want to do. Be careful.
Yes.
that we use, because those words will backfire. Those words will come back. And a lot of people think, amen, amen. I had some people just, amen, to tell me, said, well, you ain't free, amen, unless, amen, you're able to do this and you're able to do that. You ain't free. You ain't free. You ain't really free. You still in bondage. No, I'm not in bondage. But I'm free. Because I allow God to lead me. Are you allowing God to lead you on tonight? Are you allowing God to really lead you on tonight? Because see, you have to be careful that you're not, amen, conformed even to this world.
That's right.
Because see, when you are conformed to this world, amen, you can't bring it, amen. So what do you mean by that? When you are conformed to the world, you want to do what the world do.
Amen.
You want to act like the world. Amen. You want to, amen, amen, you want to be with the world. Amen.
Amen.
But the scriptures that don't be conformed to this world, but be, amen, transformed by the renewing of your mind. Amen. And if we got to let the word of God, amen, amen, renew our mind, we got to be set free. Amen. By the word of God on tonight.
Amen. That's right.
Let's go to Ephesians 3 and 12 on tonight. Ephesians 3 and 12. I had some once in my life, a little while back, I had some young people to tell me, ain't no man gonna tell me what to do. But they were sinners. And that's why you have so many young folks the way you should serve them. You'll be conformed to this world. And you'll be thinking and saying what the world's saying. And you'll think you're free, but you're not free, because you're letting the world drive your decisions. You're letting the world drive your actions. You're letting the world drive your attitude. Amen. So are you really free when you allow the world to do that? Are you really free when you allow the world to drive you into thinking, amen, certain things? You allow the world to drive you, amen, to, amen, amen, dress in a certain way.
Amen.
Ephesians 3 and 12. It said, in whom we have boldness according with confidence by the faith of him. Wherefore I desire that ye faint not in my tribulations for you, which is your glory. They go on and say, for this cause I bow my knees unto the Father, our Lord Jesus Christ, of whom the whole family in heaven and the earth is named. That he will grant you according to the riches of his glory, to be strengthened with might by his Spirit in the inner man, that Christ may dwell in your hearts by faith, that ye be rooted and grounded in love. And may ye be able to comprehend with all saints what is the breadth and length and the depth and the height. And to know the love of Christ which passeth knowledge, that ye might be filled with all the fullness of God. Now unto him that is able to do exceedingly abundantly, above all that we ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us. Let's look at that scripture. Now unto him that is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we ask or think. We got to let God do it for us. Amen.
Amen.
Because when we try to do it in our own way of thinking, and our own way of asking, his asking and his thinking on us, amen, it exceeds our thoughts. It exceeds our ways. And unto him be glory in the church by Christ Jesus throughout all ages, world without end. Amen.
Amen.
Let's turn to Galatians, the fifth chapter. What are we talking about on tonight?
Free.
What are we talking about on tonight?
Free.
Galatians 5 and 1. If you all have it, say amen.
Amen.
Stand fast, therefore, in the liberty wherewith Christ has made us free. What did it say?
Hey!
and see what the enemy is saying.
Amen.
But when you get free in Christ Jesus, and when you know the truth, it's going to make you free. It's going to make you free to obey God.
Amen.
It's going to make you free to not fear. Amen. It's going to make you free to do, amen, what exactly God wants you to do. It's going to make you free to live this life before the Lord. It's going to make you free to praise and worship the Lord. I don't care who watching you or looking at you. It's going to make you free, amen, amen, to read your word. It's going to make you free, amen, to pray unto God. Amen. It's going to make you free, amen, to live for God. It's going to make you free to not be ashamed of the gospel.
Amen.
It's going to make you free to not fellowship with your sister and brother when you see them. Amen. I don't care who's around. You know, you have some people when they get around certain people, amen, and you know, just so that, come here. If I'm around her and we know, amen, she's a saint of God, and I'm a saint of God, and you may know something to her, and they come up, amen, but you know that turn away because you don't want nobody to see you talking to sister. Because see, she's saved, she holy, or I don't want to be associated with her. Because see, they don't see it. They don't realize, they don't recognize it. Then you truly ain't, you truly ain't free. You living what? You living a lie.
Amen.
Because you don't want to associate and say, this is my sister.
Amen.
And if she's living holy, you gotta be, this is my sister.
Amen. Yes,
sir. I ain't gonna just because I see somebody from the old past, I see somebody from the old time, I'm gonna, like, oh, I don't know her. be free all the way.
Amen, that's right.
Free means not under the control or in the power of another. And when you allow the enemy to control your thoughts, control your actions, control your ways, you're not free. And anybody can tell you, we live by the word of God here. We live by the word of God here. But there's one thing that we teach you. We're making disciples so you can go out and be what God has called you to be. We don't hold nobody captive. We don't hold nobody in bondage. But if the God is in you and God is moving you, you better obey God. Because at the end of the day, the word will say, he did run away. Who did tell you that you should not obey the truth? This persuasion cometh not of him that calleth you. A little later, now hold on. I have confidence in you through the Lord that you will be none otherwise minded. But he that troubled you shall bear his children, whosoever he be. And I, brother, if I yet preach circumcision, why do I yet suffer persecution? Then is the offense of the cross stopped. I would that they were even cut off, which trouble you. Let's go on now. For brother, ye have been called unto liberty. Liberty means what? Freedom.
Free.
You have been called to what?
Liberty.
Liberty. God called us to liberty. God called us to come out of those old ways. Sin. For brother, ye have been called unto liberty. Only use not liberty for an occasion to the flesh. Alright, we're going to deal with this scripture right here. A lot of people, they're doing it. They're doing it. It says, for brother, this was talking to the sinners, but this was talking to the saints of God. It says, for brethren, ye have been called unto liberty. Only use not liberty for an occasion to the flesh, but by love serve one another. That's going to use your freedom so you can satisfy this flesh.
Amen.
This flesh craves out a lot of things. And if you satisfy this flesh, you won't get in trouble with God. You get wrapped up in your flesh, you're going to get in trouble with the Lord. Because the flesh is an enemy to God. Y'all hear me?
Amen.
The flesh will keep you in bondage. The flesh will not allow you to obey God.
Amen.
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 For all the law is fulfilled in one word, even in this, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. We should do what? We should love our neighbor as thyself. So I got a little red on here. I got a little red on the coat. People that are on it, I got to love them. I ain't got to love the sin, but I got to love them.
Amen.
He wants us to love one another.
That's it.
And the love, it is wet, cold in these days. You can't feel the love like you used to could feel the love.
Amen.
Because you know what? People have gotten wrapped up in their flesh. They have gotten wrapped up in their own way of thinking.
Yes.
To the point, they're not loving the way they should. But if you fight and devour one another, take heed that ye be not consumed woman of another. Then I say then, I want everybody to read verse 16 with me. After the count of three, 1, 2, 3. This I say then, woe is the spirit, and ye shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. Now, that's not just talking about the sexual lust of the flesh. Yeah, that's in it too. But I'm talking about the things that craves are the things you know you don't need.
Amen, that's it.
It could be food. You may have a problem with shopping. You might be a shopaholic. I'm just saying, I'm just calling out some stuff. You might be a porkaholic. So what's a porkaholic? Somebody love pork, I'm telling you, I just know you have to worry. The lust of the flesh. The flesh lusts against the spirit, and the spirit against the flesh. And these are contrary the one to the other, so that ye cannot do the things that ye would. Let me read that again. For the flesh lusts against the spirit, and the spirit against the what? The flesh. And these are contrary the one to the other, so that ye cannot do the things that ye would. So in other words, if you can't do what God is telling you to do, then you're not free.
Man.
But if you do that on the spirit, you are not under the law. Now the works of the flesh are manifest, which are these, adultery. Everybody know what adultery is on tonight?
Amen.
Anybody need me to break that down?
Amen.
All right.
No.
Fornication. Everybody know what fornication is on tonight? Kids, y'all know what fornication is?
Amen.
All right. You sure? If you don't, we'll break it down tonight. Hey, they ain't too young.
They
got all this stuff on TV.
They sure
do.
Uncleanness, lasciviousness, idolatry, witchcraft, hatred, variance, emulations, wrath, strife, seditions, heresies, envious, murders, drunkenness, rebellions, and such like of the which I tell you before. If you find yourself in any of these things, you are not free. You're still in bondage.
Amen.
You're entangled with the word of bondage. And you haven't got free.
Amen. That's it.
You need deliverance. Which I tell you before, and I've also told you in time past, that they which do such things shall not inherit what?
The kingdom of God.
You ain't gonna make it. If you did any of this stuff, you're not gonna make it in. You're not gonna make it in. It's simple as that. But the fruit of the Spirit is love. Do you have love on tonight?
Amen.
For everybody.
Amen.
Do you have joy?
Yes.
Even when you might have a $300, $400, $600, $700 bill that's due.
Uh-huh.
Do you still have that joy?
Amen.
Is you still going to love the Lord?
Yes.
All right now.
Yes, I will.
Peace. Are you still going to love him?
Yes.
Is you still going to have that peace or know that he's going to be there?
Yes, Lord.
In the midst of a storm.
Amen.
But the doctor might give you a bad report.
Mm-hmm.
Are you going to have a peace?
Yeah.
Yeah. Long suffering. Somebody make you mad on your job. Somebody make you mad in your family. Are you still going to suffer long?
Come on.
And keep that love.
Come on.
All right. When you just having a bad day, are you still gonna be gentle to people? Are you just gonna just be so just frustrated? Don't want to deal with nobody. Don't want to be around anybody. Goodness still gotta be good. The word of God said everything that God made, it was good. In the beginning, it was good.
Amen.
Why do you think that goodness there? The word would have never grown if Jesus Christ didn't know that we could do this, that we could live by this. Because you know, it takes God to do it. It takes Jesus Christ to be in your life to do it. It takes being free to operate in these things. Meekness, being humble. Not fool of yourself. Not fool your ways and your thoughts. Temperance, not getting angry. But against such there is no law. And they that are Christ have crucified the flesh with the affections and lust. If we live in the Spirit, let us also walk in the Spirit. Let us be not desirous of vainglory. We should never want God's glory.
Amen.
All glory belongs to God. We're His vessels, so His glory can be manifested through us. Let us not be desirous of vainglory, provoking one another, envying one another. My last scripture, let's turn to Romans. Romans the 6th chapter. Romans the 6th chapter. I'm just going to go ahead and start at that first verse. Now I want you to focus in on this passage of scripture in the 6th chapter. I want you to go home after this Bible study and I want you to read Romans the 6th chapter. And if you want to be a slave to anything, the best thing to be a slave to,
amen,
is righteousness.
Amen.
Y'all hear me on tonight.
Amen.
We've been set free, those that are free on tonight, from the hands of the enemy. And the only thing that you want to be a slave to,
amen,
is righteousness. Romans the 6th chapter in the 1st verse says, what shall we say then? Shall we continue in sin that grace may abound? God forbid. In other words, he said no. He don't want you to abound. He don't want you to continue in sin. He don't want you to continue to sin. And how shall we that are dead to sin live any longer therein? Know ye not that so many of us as were baptized in Jesus Christ were baptized into his death? Therefore we are buried with him by baptism into death, like that like as Christ was raised up from the dead by the glory of the Father, even so we also should walk in the newness of life. When we have been planted together in the likeness of his death, we shall be also in the likeness of his resurrection. Knowing this, that our old man is crucified with him, that the body of sin might be destroyed, that henceforth we should not do what?
Serve sin.
Serve sin. For he that is dead is freed from sin. Let's read that again. For he that is dead is free from sin. How do you die? You die by taking Jesus Christ on. The fourth verse of the sixth shows that therefore we the bear with him by the baptism into death. That like as Christ was raised up from the dead by the glory of the Father, even so we also should walk in the newness of life. And but so now if we be dead with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. Knowing that Christ being raised from the dead died no more. Death had no more dominion over him. So if death has no more dominion over him, death has no more dominion over us. Amen. And we are free from sin. For in him that he died unto sin once. But in that he lived unto God. Meaning he died for our sins. He paid the price on the cross. Likewise, ready ye also yourselves to be dead indeed unto sin, but alive unto God through Jesus Christ our Lord. Let not sin therefore reign in your mortal body. Don't let sin abide in this body. That ye should obey it in the lust thereof. Neither yield your members as instruments of unrighteousness unto sin. But yield yourselves unto who? Anybody following? Anybody following in the world tonight? It said, the 13th verse said, neither yield ye your members as instruments of unrighteousness unto sin, but yield yourselves unto who?
God.
As those that are alive from the dead, and your members as instruments of righteousness unto God. The sin shall not have dominion over you. Ye are not under the law, but under grace. Where then shall we see it? Because we are not under the law, but under grace? God forbid. Just because you're under grace, that don't make you free to sin. Mm-hmm. Sin shall not abide. Know ye not that to whom ye yield yourself servants to obey. Listen at this. Know ye not that to whom ye yield yourself servants to obey, his servants ye are to whom ye obey. So if you obey him, the devil on tonight, that's your servant.
Uh-huh.
That's who you serve. That's who you enslaved to. That's who you in bondage to. Free set, not under the control or in the power of another, able to act and be done as one wishes. But guess what? If you're not free on tonight, you're acting under, amen, the servant, amen, of the devil.
Uh-huh.
Whether well, sin unto death or the obedience unto righteousness. But God be thanked that ye were the servants of sin. But ye have obeyed from the heart that the form of doctrine which was delivered you. Being then made free from sin, you became the servants of what?
Righteousness.
I speak after the manner of men because of the infirmity of your flesh, whereas ye have yielded your members servants to uncleanness and iniquity unto iniquity. Even so now yield your members servants to righteousness unto what?
Holiness.
It's a lifestyle, y'all.
Uh-huh.
It's a lifestyle. It's your actions. It's your purity that you possess. What fruit had ye then in those things? Well, ye are not ashamed, for the end of those things is death. Being made free from sin and become servants to God, ye have your free fruit unto what? The end is everlasting life. For the wages of sin is what?
Death.
The wages of sin is what?
Death.
But the gift of God is what?
Eternal life.
Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Are you free on tonight?
Amen.
Are you free on tonight?
Amen.
If you're free on tonight, stay free.
Amen.
If you're not free, seek to be free.
Amen.